goof around. Stop, look, and laugh when those crazy chimpanzees do the things that people do. Call it monkey business if you please, but if it pleases you, then get in and join the fun. Stop, look, and laugh, and we do meet everyone. Stop, look, and laugh, here's the show where you can bet. It's the show you won't forget. So on your marks, get set, and stop.
Come on, Jerry. Up and at him.
Oh, no. What time is it, Lynch?
7:30.
It can't be. It's still dark out.
Hey, that's right. It's usually light by 7:30.
I guess the clock is wrong.
Oh, well, you can go back to sleep.
Thanks, Lynch.
It's funny. The clock has never been wrong before. But it sure is dark out. Boy, it's pitch black. Well, I guess I'll let in some fresh air. You like that little character. He painted the window black, so I think it was still night out. Jerry. Jerry!
Don't holler.
Well, then rise and shine. Remember, the early bird catches the worm.
Yuck. I don't like worms. Wake me up for toast and coffee.
No, 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 you don't. No, don't go back to sleep. Now, look, you've been late for school twice this week. Now, come on, let's go.
Oh, I'm so tired.
That's too bad. Come on, now, you just get washed and hurry along. I guess I'll put on the coffee. There. Ought to be ready in a minute or two. Jerry. Hey, Jerry, hurry up, will you? I want to get washed, too. Jerry? Jerry!
Don't holler! Don't holler!
How did you get back in bed?
It's easy. When I came out of the bathroom, I made a left turn at the dresser.
Jerry, I don't understand. Every day it gets harder and harder to get you out of bed. Now, come on. You've got to get washed and you've got to go to school.
Yeah, but...
Never mind, Bus. Just get in there and hurry it up, will you? Oh, that kid. Every day, the same thing. Jerry? Jerry?
Don't holler.
Now, look, you. Look, you come with me, you see? I've had enough of this nonsense. Now, into the closet. Come on, take off your pajamas and put on your clothing. And hurry it up, young man. I want to see a little speed. That's what I call speed. You ready, Jerry? Jerry? Oh, no, not again. Jerry? Jerry? Now, where did he go to? Jerry!
Don't holler!
Look, you, come on with me. You and I are going to have breakfast. Look, you, if you don't start showing some energy, you're going to do very, very badly in school.
I don't think I'm going to do so hot anyway.
Why not?
Well, we got a couple of tests today.
On what?
On how the world began.
You don't know how the world began?
Well, it was a little bit before my time.
Very funny. Well, it's a little late now, but perhaps I can explain it to you fast. Now, in the very beginning, everything was darkness. 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 Then suddenly there was light. Then came the first image of man.
Hey, Bo, let him!
Fred out.
All a wise guy, eh?
And then came water. 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 And more water.
That's all for today. How many of you guys are riveters?
Here we are.
Yeah, right here.
Oh. At your service, buddy.
We are the best riveters that ever riveted.
Okay, we pay $1 an hour.
Well, you just hired yourself 3 good men.
Yeah.
Where do we start?
On the 97th floor.
97th floor?
Hop on that girder and get up to work.
Hurry up, lame brain. Hey, what's that thing?
In case we gotta bail out. Hey, Mo!
Don't ever do that, you dummy.
Get him while they're hot.
On the section, Mr. Blake.
Well, how are they working out?
Haven't checked on them yet.
Well, it looks like good, solid construction. You know, you...
Solid construction, eh? Where are those 3 new men?
Why, they've been working up above there, they...
What do you mean by hiring men like them?
A hot one right off the griddle.
Oh, you dummy!
Oh. Get those men off of this building!
Go on, hurry up! Come on, I hope that parachute works! Open the parachute!
Knucklehead. Say, Jerry left already. You better hurry. You'll be late for school.
Why are you going to school, Mr. Winkle?
Oh, you too? Listen, Knuck. Let's talk about it, shall we? What is it?
Oh, it ain't no use, sir. They can't teach me nothing.
Knucklehead. Hmm? They can't teach me anything.
Oh, you must be stupid too, huh?
Look, what seems to be the trouble?
Well... It's all of your homework I gotta do.
Oh, let me see it.
Right here.
Oh, well, they just want you to write a composition about George Washington.
Mm-hmm.
You know who George Washington was?
Oh, certainly. He used to stand like this.
No, that was Napoleon.
No, Washington.
Knucklehead, when did Washington ever stand like that?
When he was wearing itchy underwear.
Oh, look, why don't we try... A little simpler subject. Now tell me, how are you with arithmetic?
Oh, great. Just terrific. There's only one thing I don't know.
What's that?
What's arithmetic?
All right, we'll do something very, very easy. Now tell me, how much is one and one?
Could you give me a hint?
All right, hold up a finger.
Okay.
How much is that?
One.
Now hold up another finger.
Okay.
And how much is that?
11.
Just put down one finger.
All right.
Now, what have you got?
I got a hangnail. Have you got a thither, sir? Please.
Oh, knucklehead, you're completely exasperating, frustrating, and incorrigible.
Gee, I wish you'd tell it to my mother. She thinks I'm a jerk.
Oh, no.
Oh, it's no use, Mr. Winkle. I'm hopeless.
Oh, don't say that, knucklehead. Nobody is hopeless. Look, let me tell you a little story. I once knew three fellows.
Yeah?
And, well, they weren't too bright, but they were gas station attendants, you see.
Uh-huh.
Well, one day, a big car pulled up for service.
What'll it be, stranger?
Put in 10 gallons of gas. I'm going to cross street for a sandwich.
Well, I guess we might as well have lunch here, gentlemen.
Yeah.
Hey, can you guys give me a little help? I need some repairs.
We're pretty busy, pal, but we'd be glad to let you use the tools. Save us from waiting on the job. All right, men, a little super service. You check the battery, you check the tires.
What are you going to check?
I'm going to check you guys.
Right. Don't worry about nothing. Stop it! Are you hurt? Are you all right?
Get up out of there. Don't stand around idle. You put in the water, you put in the gas. Get moving.
Right.
Sorry, gents, but this can happen in the best of places. Now, hold still now. Just a minute, I'll have a towel right away.
Stop that!
Just take it easy, fellas.
Fire
under him and thaw him out. Come on, get him into the woods.
Get your arm under here.
Okay. Up we go. Only minutes to a pound.
Get me off here. I'm trying to...
He's burning, though.
All right, he's down. I'll get you.
Are you all right?
Give me your hand.
Give me your hand. Give me your hand. Give me your hand.
Well, Jerry's in school and I'm all by myself at last. No trouble, no mischief, no noise. The silence is driving me out of my mind. Oh, well, he'll be home soon. Say, what's that sign on his dresser? Open drawers at your own risk.
Oh!
Ouch! Ooh! Ooh! Oh! Oh! Just like that kid to have this booby trapped. Look out! Ow! Ow! Ooh! 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 Jerry! What am I yelling for? He's not here. Jerry's baby picture. Gee, he was a cute little baby. Oh, what's the matter, sweetheart? Oh, come on, up we go, up we go. Oh, yes, indeed. Oh, little baby wants some foodie, doesn't he? Come over here, and great big daddies will give him some food, all right?
Just get out of here.
Oh, isn't that cute? Now, here's some nice foodsy-woozy. Come on, sweetheart, open your mouth.
No.
Come on.
You first.
Daddy first?
Mm-hmm.
If Daddy have some, then will Baby have some?
Cuckoo.
All right, first Daddy. Delicious, see? Now, some for little baby.
No.
Baby must have some. All right, we have some Milky Wilky. Come on, little bit of Milky. Come on now, little bit. No, 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 no. Swallow that now. Swallow it now. No, 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 no. I swallow it now.
Who that?
Who what? Why did... Oh, I know what's wrong. Oh, baby has to make a bubble. All right, sweetheart. Come on now. Make a little bubble for Daddy. Let's have a little burpsy-werpsy. Come on, sweetheart. Make a bubble. Oh, that came all the way up from your toesies, you sweet little baby.
That came up from your toesies, you phony ventriculus.
Jerry, was that nice?
I'm sorry, Dada.
Dada. He called me Dada. Oh, no, 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 no. Oh. Hey. That's a real baby crying. I wonder where that's coming from.
Where's that cat?
I'll murder it. Kitty, 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 kitty!
What do you know, a baby?
Oh, a lovely baby.
Isn't he cute? Watch me make him laugh. Zip, boom,
cuckoo. Oh, you don't know how to make a baby laugh. Watch this.
Look, honey, look.
Kid's unhappy.
So am I.
Look at that back. Oh, God, look at me.
Here we are.
Boy,
there we go. There we are.
Okay. Hey, where are you?
Here, here.
Oh, there you are. Boys, all we need is a few slight alterations. Stand by, Doc. Scissors.
Scissors.
Pin. Pin. Scissors. Pin. Pin. Pin.
Pin.
Pin.
Pin. Wait till you see the meal we have for you.
There we are. There's enchiladas, spaghetti, artichokes, onions, celery, olives, radishes, pig's feet, and herring. Come on, get gone.
There we are, ready or not.
Look, a nice radish.
Try an olive. Oh!
Get a load of these headlines. Police scour city for kidnapped baby.
Oh, that's nothing. Kids always get into mischief. Now, when I was a kid, I... Kidnapped? Who, what, when? Let me see.
There.
Police fear kidnappers have grabbed Collins' baby and are holding it for ransom. So far, the kidnappers have not contacted the family.
The kidnappers got cold feet and left us with a kid with a phony note.
Hey, bunion head, answer that door.
We don't...
Hey, fellas, it's the cop. They're after us for kidnapping.
We gotta hide the evidence. Let me see now.
The window.
Scram!
Pigeons in this car.
Yeah.
It's the baby. It's in the car.
Yeah. Now we're in for it. Everything will be all right as long as the kid keeps quiet.
I'll cut a hole in the canvas and see where the cops are.
Good idea. And if you see it, let me know.
Hey, there's somebody out here honking his horn.
Yeah, it's you. You don't get it.
Those guys!
All right.
Spread out. I got a signal for a turn.
Get your gun. It may be violent. Stick him up!
Stick him up!
Baby!
Oh, my baby.
Darling, my baby.
I'm sorry we quarreled last night.
Me too. I was so despondent. That's why I left Jimmy on that doorstep.
Well, don't worry. It won't happen again.
No.
Say, what do you suppose became of those three goofs? You got me. They still don't know that all we wanted was a baby. Yeah.
Say, I didn't realize it was that late. I better call the garage and see if my car's been fixed yet. Acme Garage. Mulligan speaking.
Mr. Mulligan, this is Winchell. Paul Winchell.
Is my car ready? You know, the one I borrowed from my army friend?
He said it would be fixed today.
Hang on, Mr. Winchell. Hey, Charlie, check on Mr. Winchell's car, will you?
You, Mo?
Come on out of that car. Get up there and take care of the motor. Suffocating.
Come on, we gotta get him out. no use. We can't get him out this way.
Wait a minute. Maybe this will help. No use. Oh! The anvil! Let's break it off!
Stay out of here, will you, fellas?
Take your time, take your time.
Now look, lay it right down there like that.
Oh, no, no, take it easy.
Four?
Oh!
Say, if we heat it, it'll slip off.
Why didn't I think of that?
Come on, let's get going. Okay.
Hot enough.
It's too hot. Let's put in the water and cool it off.
Help! Help!
Hey, let's put his head in the vise and yank it off.
Jugheads, you'll never get this thing together in time. Hey, here comes Kelly. I'll stall him off while you guys get the parts back in.
Looks pretty good. Say, that winch here looks so clean you wouldn't know there was any glass in it.
You said it!
Did you get that squeak out?
Boy, we got everything out.
I'll drive it right out.
Now, wait a minute, Kelly. Listen, there's one little thing that
never mind. I'm in a hurry. Sounds good.
Hello, Mr. Winchell?
Oh, yes. Is my car finished?
It's finished, Mr. Winchell. But it ain't ready.
Okay. So long.
Oh, boy, oh, boy. Look at all this food.
Well, I'm glad you like it, Jerry. Well, everything is ready.
Oh, am I hungry, Winch? Am I hungry?
No, no. Hmm? No. What's your manners? Stop reaching. What's the matter with you? Haven't you got a tongue?
Yeah, but my arm is longer.
Oh, here. Have a piece of corn.
Oh, thanks, Winch.
But eat it like a gentleman.
Yes, sir.
Gently.
Mm-hmm.
Sweetly.
Mm-hmm.
Lovingly. Tenderly.
I'll just kiss it and put it back.
Oh, go ahead and eat it. Can you stop long enough to answer one question?
Oh, sure. What is it, Winch?
How did you do in school today?
I got 100 and everything.
You did? Oh, Jerry, I'm so thrilled. Are you telling me the truth?
No, but I sure had you living there for a while.
Oh, no.
And this afternoon, it's even going to be worse.
Why?
She's going to ask questions about Mexico.
Mexico?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I can help you there.
You can?
Certainly. Now, let's see. Mexico is a beautiful country.
Mm-hmm.
Each year, thousands of people from all over the world come to see its many wonders.
Ladies and gentlemen, as another attraction, we wish to present those loco Americanos comedians, the Three Stooges. They will do a comedy bullfight. We hope you like them too many. Thank you.
Queen of the Fiesta, I dedicate this bull. And I do mean bull.
Suelta en el toro.
Ah, gracias. Sí, sí, señor.
Come on, fellas, let's get going.
Come on, what are you stalling for? Get going, they're waiting for something. Come on, charge me. Charge me.
Fellas. The act is going over great. Look at that audience.
Hey, what are you doing over there when you belong over here? You get the...
Close call, kid. He almost got you. For a break for this act, and you come along and ruin it. I'm mad. I'm furious. Fight like a man.
Come on, Jerry, hurry up. You'll be late for this afternoon's class.
This afternoon's class. Boy, oh boy, if I flunked the test this morning, I hate to think what I'll do this afternoon. If Winch thought that I was sick, then he wouldn't send me. This'll do it. Now, I'll just put one over here. Another one there.
Listen, Jerry, didn't you hear me? Now, come on. You've got to get to school this afternoon. Why are you covering your face? Jerry.
Huh?
Your face.
Yuck. What are you yucking about?
Well, it's all covered with dots.
Well, what do you expect, dashes?
Well, what is it?
Chicken pox.
Chicken pox. Are you sure?
Sure, I'm sure. Listen.
Yeah, but... it can't be chicken pox. The spots are only on your face.
That's the worst kind. From the neck down, I got feathers.
Jerry, if you've got chicken pox, then I can't send you to school.
What? I must go to school if it kills me.
No, I can't let you go.
I must go.
I can't let you go.
I must.
I can't. Well...
keep fighting me. Keep fighting me. Here.
Yeah. Wait a minute. I'll take your temperature. I'll get a thermometer.
Who needs it?
Here. Open your mouth.
Yeah, but I...
open it. Open your mouth, I say. What's the matter?
Watch the mechanism.
Oh, here, put it back. Put it back. I'll get you some hot tea. I'll get you some hot tea.
Uh-oh. It's normal. What'll I... This ought to do it. You give me fever, fever. He's scouty da 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 da.
Now you drink this, you'll feel better.
Uh-oh.
Hey, I said that thermometer in.
Yeah, but you don't seem to... I said in.
Now, what does it say? 264.
264.
264? Jerry, I better get the doctor.
Wait a second, Winch. Wait a second.
What's the matter?
I'm going fast.
What?
This is it. So long, old pal.
Jerry, wait a minute. Hang on.
So long. I'm going to die. I'm dead.
You are not dead. You're alive.
You call this living?
Jerry.
Winch, it's getting dark.
Jerry, what's the matter? Hold on.
It's getting dark. I can't see you. Turn the lights on. Where are you?
The lights are on. Don't you see me now?
Yeah, turn them off again.
I better get the doctor. That's what I'll do. I'll get the doctor. I'll call the hospital. The hospital, yes. What's the number? Oh, the hospital.
My baby, my poor little garçon.
Oh, calm yourself, Mrs. Bedford. He's in the hands of the world's greatest specialist. They'll pull him through.
I hope so.
Do you think it's serious, Dr. Curley?
Yes, indeed, to say the least, if not less. The perambulation of the pedal extremity is impeded by the insertion of a foreign botanical offshoot. Now, gentlemen, we must proceed with caution. This Bedford dog is worth a fortune.
So it is.
The instruments.
The instruments.
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 Ah, the tools. Anacalapon.
Anacalapon.
Anacalapon. Piddle ditatar.
Go get a piddle ditatar.
We have none.
We have none.
Oh, yes, we have.
No. Hold it, Doctor. This is going to hurt me worse than it does you, Garson. Oh, hold on. Success.
How is Garçon? Is she all right?
The operation was a complete success.
That's wonderful. Now I can show Garçon in the dog show tomorrow. Come, Garçon.
No, he must rest here for a few hours.
Yes, we'll have her back about 4 o'clock.
We'll see that Garçon gets the very best of attention.
Oh, yes, madame.
Thank you. Good day, gentlemen.
Good day. Nurse! Put the dog to bed.
Dr. Moe, Dr. Larry, Dr. Curley. What do you want? Two important visitors to see you.
Okay. Hey, that mouse must have eaten catnip. One little kitten lost its mitten. How careless.
Here they come now. How do you do, gentlemen? We're from the Daily Star.
We'd like to get up a feature story about your hospital.
That's fine. Follow us. We'd be happy to show you around. Here's an interesting case, gentlemen.
What's wrong with him?
He suffered from acute alcoholism.
Ain't he a cutie? No. He's a lap dog.
A lap dog?
Yeah, he lapped up 2 cases of beer. A bad case.
Keep a cool head, kid.
Now, right this way, gentlemen.
Dr. Moe, Dr. Larry, Dr. Curley.
Who's Garson?
That's Mrs. Bedford's prize poodle.
Oh.
Calling Dr. Curley. Calling Dr. Curley. Calling Dr. Larry. Calling Dr. Larry. Calling Dr. Moe. Pomeranian in Ward 6 has a coat on its tongue. What should we do?
Give him the pants and vest and take him for a walk.
Pardon me.
Come on, we gotta pull this job in a hurry.
We'll hide him in the old house until we get the ransom.
Calling all curs. Calling all curs. Dinner is ready. Come to the dining room. That is all.
Don't worry, there's enough for everybody. Take a look at this.
Dr. Moe, Larry, Curly, Garçon is missing. Come at once. Hurry.
Garçon!
Garçon!
my gossip!
Oh, what do we do? Read this note?
What happened? Where's Garson?
He's gone. Here, read this note.
Mrs. Bedford can have her dog if she pays $2,000. Don't tell the cops or she will never see him again. Those guys weren't reporters, they were dog nappers. I got an idea.
I wonder what he's up to.
Sit down, Ann. Now, here's the idea. We gotta disguise this mutt to look like Garson. The old lady won't know the difference. Get to work on that mattress. Nice, get the glue. You get the black paint. Stop pulling, boys.
He looks more like Garson than Garson. Nobody will ever recognize him.
That mattress here turned the trick.
We brought Mrs. Bedford's dog back.
All right, but keep it away from me. I don't like dogs.
Come on, come on.
Just wait right in here, gentlemen. Madam will be right in. Go away, dog. Go away. You are scalped. I'm getting out of here.
How do you do, doctors? Well, where is Garson?
Right here.
Yes.
Garson.
Hey, Garson.
Hey, Garson.
Hey,
Garson.
Garson. Garson.
Yeah. Hey, Garson.
Here he is.
Here.
That's not my dog.
Go. Chief Anna, get something. Do something.
All right.
Do
don't
something.
Worry.
Ah! You fiends. You vandals. What have you done with my dog?
I'm sorry, lady. We made a mistake. We brought
you get my dog back or I'll have the police on you.
We'll bring him back.
Why? You'd better.
Garson.
Hey, Garson. Garson.
Garson.
I tell you, the jig is up, boys. I can see us in jail.
Yeah, on a rock pile, making little ones out of big ones.
Listen, bloodhound, if you've got any blood in you, you'll find Garson. Now go on, do your stuff.
Look, he's gonna find him. Come on.
He sees someone. He's calling us.
When did he make up his mind?
Quiet, we'll find out. Come on.
I wonder why we haven't heard from the owner of that dog.
Search me.
Come on, he's on a scent.
Yep.
We're looking for a dog.
He had four legs and a tail.
No, I ain't seen no dog.
It's them!
The dog nappers!
Come on!
Look. Get him, bro! Hold him still! Give it to him! Give it to him! Sock him!
Wait a minute, let me at him. I'll mop up the floor with him.
Don't worry, Jerry. Everything will be all right.
Why don't those doctors show up? Oh, I know what I'll do. I'll get you a cold compress. There. That'll cool off your head a little bit. Here. Here. Just doesn't that feel good? There. Doesn't that...
Uh-oh.
Faking, huh? Just to stay home from school.
Now, wait a second, Lynch.
Don't you wait a second, me. You're going to be punished. Now, you go to school right now.
But I can't. It's too late.
Well, then go in the other room and do your homework.
I ain't got it.
Well, Knucklehead has got it. I'll go right over to Knucklehead's house right now, and I'll get your homework.
But Knucklehead ain't home right now. He's working over at his uncle's restaurant.
All right. Then I'll go right over to his uncle's restaurant, and I'll get the homework right now.
Your coffee's great, knucklehead. Thanks a lot. How much do I owe you?
Oh, for you, Officer Joe, no charge.
So long.
So long. I'll see you in court. That's a funny one.
In court. What a guy.
Hi, knucklehead.
Oh, hello there, Mr. Winkle. What can I do for you?
Well, may I borrow Jerry's homework assignment for today?
Oh, certainly. I got it right here, sir.
Thank you.
Here it is, right here.
Oh, good.
Listen, while you're here, would you like something to eat?
All right, knucklehead, give me a salad.
Yes, sir. One salad coming up.
Oh, is that a tossed salad?
Hmm?
I like a tossed salid. Would you toss it for me?
Well, if that's what you want.
Please. Knucklehead.
Huh?
Look, just make me a sandwich, please.
Okay. One sandwich coming up.
Oh, on raisin bread, if you don't mind.
Oh, of course I don't mind. Not at all.
Oh, is that raisin bread fresh?
Why, sir.
Uh-oh. What's the matter?
What'd you do that for? One of the raisins was walking.
Oh, for goodness. There's your homework. Get busy.
Hey, Winch, can I do it later?
Later?
Yeah, my favorite TV show is on now.
Well, okay. I guess another half hour can't do any harm.
It's a lie.
Come on, let's get the horses.
Okay, you've seen your television show. Now get busy and do your homework.
Oh, gee whiz, Winch.
I said do your homework. I'm going to have some water.
All right, all right. Gee, what a grouch.
It's funny. Hey, Jerry.
Yeah?
Would you do me a favor and let your homework go and come in here for a minute? Something's wrong with the faucet. It doesn't work.
Okay, Lynch. What is it?
Oh, look, you see that little
valve down there.
This one?
Mm-hmm. When I say all right, will you turn that on, please?
Okay.
No, but not now. Just wait till I say all right, then turn it on.
When you say all right, I turn it on.
Yeah.
Hey, Winch.
Yeah?
How's it coming?
All right. What's a big idea?
Well, you said all right. Hey, Winch.
Yeah?
How come this other valve is green?
Green? Oh, that's just a little corrosion.
Yeah?
Yeah. They're both supposed to be all white. Look, you! I said all white! I didn't say all right! Look, do me a favor. Don't touch anything, will you, please? Leave everything alone. I'll go call the plumbers. Plumbers.
Sorry, Winch.
No. Let's see.
Well, Winch?
No answer. He must be out on a job.
Just a second! Let me have that wrench. You imbeciles!
Hey, boys, I must be dead. I hear an angel singing.
Miss Andrews, and very nice, too.
Thank you.
I'll see that Mrs. Bixby hears this record, and I hope she'll hire you for her program. But I still can't understand why you won't audition for her in person.
My father doesn't approve of my being a radio singer, so I have to do it under an assumed name.
Well, I follow you so far.
Well, if Mrs. Bixby hires me, my father can't object because she's an old family friend. That's simple enough, isn't it?
Oh, sure, sure.
I'm sorry, Mo. It was an accident.
Where's the idea?
Hello, what's the matter?
Tell me what's going on here. Pick up that stuff and get to work. So help me, this your last...
Boy, right on the head.
I'm gonna cut you all into pieces!
Oh, a microphony!
And a phony at the mic!
Get over there! Quiet, numbskulls, I'm broadcasting.
Hey, Winch.
Yeah, Jerry?
Any luck yet?
No, I still can't get the plumbers.
Hey, go out in the front yard and shut the water off.
Hey, what's going on here? Hey! Hey! Turn me loose!
said you need brains to be a plumber.
Why, you lame brain, you! Look what you did to the pipe! Oh, get another piece of pipe!
I resent that!
What are you gonna do about it?
Get another piece of pipe, wait a minute.
Making a television broadcast direct from Niagara Falls.
There. I hope you sleep tight, Nuck.
Say, this twinkle.
Yeah.
You know, at home, I never go to sleep unless my father tells me a story.
Oh, really? Well, what kind of a story does he tell you?
Well, he tells me Robinson Crusoe and his man Saturday.
You mean Friday?
No, Saturday. He overslept.
Say, how would you like to hear the story of Cinderella?
Oh, that's swell.
All right. Now, let's see. Once upon a time, when knighthood was in fame, there lived a pretty slavey. Cinderella was her name.
Dearest sister, will we ever marry a handsome mister?
Oh, it's so hard to be beautiful.
This perfume should capture a man. Where's Cinderella? Our sister is never around when we need her. Cinderella! You didn't wash.
You didn't scrub.
You didn't dust.
Or clean the couch.
You didn't cook.
You didn't sew.
Get to work.
Away you go. Busy, busy me. I'm as busy as a bumblebee. Oh, busy, busy me. I'm as busy as can be. You see, I'm busy, busy gee. I've been busy all my life. I fear won't someone rescue me from this dusty chandelier. Odds, bodkins, 5-4. Who's that knocking on our door?
Hurry, Esmeralda.
Coming, Zelda. Come in, sir. Do come in.
Know ye, by all these presents, His Majesty the King, protector of the realm and sovereign of all its subjects, hereby summons you to the grand salon in the royal palace on the 8th hour of the evening of the 12th day of the 5th month of the current year.
Goody, goody, that's tonight.
And now I bow.
Theory!
We've arrived. Esmeralda!
Zelda, think of it. We're going to the ball. Goody, goody!
We're going to the ball.
You're not going.
Hurry, hurry, let's prepare.
Goodness gracious, what do we wear?
Cinderella, get my shoes. Esmeralda.
I'm rushing, Zelda. It's hard to hustle when you wear a bustle.
Poor me. I can't go to the ball.
You too can be beautiful, Cinderella. You can be the belle of the ball.
Who are you?
I'm your fairy godmother.
Goody, goody! I'm going to the ball.
Please cooperate if you want to go to the ball.
But look at my appearance.
Please be modest. I'll tell you what I'm going to do. Ippity, bippity, jippity, gee. Hocus pocus. You're a queen. Cinderella, you'll be the envy of them all. You'll truly be the belle of the ball.
But how will I get there?
Follow me. Look to the skies and close your eyes. Lumpkins, bumpkins, magic pumpkins. Presto, big surprise. You cannot go like that, my dear. Barefooted, tisn't neat. Herrings, kippers, crystal slippers, presto! For your feet.
Happy, happy me. I'm as happy as a girl can be. Oh, happy, happy me. I am going on a spree. Oh, happy, happy me. I'm filled with rapture after all. Oh, happy, happy me. I'm going to the ball.
The king and queen sat on their throne with the handsome prince at their side. Then off he glanced and was entranced as the golden coach he spied. As from the coach she did alight, the graceful prince fell in love at first sight.
You're scintillating, fascinating, devastating.
Prince never asked us to dance.
In fact, nobody asked us.
The stroke of midnight did approach.
Hurry, Cinderella, hurry! Hurry before the coach turns into a pumpkin!
Alas, poor graceful prince, he was shortchanged in the deal. His lady fair had won his heart, but lost her soul and heel.
Farewell, my fair lady. Oh, sadness, oh, sorrow. Joy today, gloom tomorrow.
Hello, pumpkin. Farewell, coach. The prince had lost his lady love. He knew not what to do, and so he sought the dainty foot to fit the crystal shoe.
Oh, darling, what big toes you have.
Cinderella, open the door.
Extend your feet in the name of the king, for the foot that fits the slipper should belong to the leg of my queen.
Here, let me try it.
Here, prince, here, prince. Here, prince.
It fits! My heart, my love, my queen!
My foot!
my bride.
Oh, Esmeralda.
Don't cry, Zelda. Oh,
just that it's been such a long day. Yeah. Look, I think that we should all turn in now, Nock.
Yeah, okay.
Good night, Knucklehead.
Oh, boy, what a mystery this is. Full of murders. I gotta find out who the killer is.
Hey, Jerry, are you still awake? Come on, it's almost 10 o'clock. Now get into bed.
Oh, I gotta stay up a little bit longer, Winch. I gotta finish and find out who the killer is.
Well, I'm sorry, Jerry. You'll have to turn out that light. We gotta get to sleep.
Oh, gee whiz, Winch. Just let me read one more chapter, huh?
Well, all right, you read one more chapter, but I've gotta get some sleep.
Gee whiz. He's out like a light. I think I'll finish my milk. Now, let's see. The killer walked in, with gun in hand. Stick him up, he said. Higher! Higher! Higher!
Help! Oh! Oh! Oh, the dam is busted! Run for the hills! Yip! Lynch! Now, look, you. I've had enough of this nonsense. Now, give me that book. We turn out the light and go to sleep.
Gee whiz, don't get sore.
Don't get sore. Let's turn it out. Now, good night, Jerry. Good night.
Okay, okay. Good night.
What's that? What's all that noise? They're having a party next door. At 2 o'clock in the morning. Well, this is ridiculous.
No, thank you, stopping.
Good evening.
Good evening.
May I introduce my three protégés, Mrs. Gottrox?
Delighted.
Devastated.
Dilapidated.
And the Counter Spritzwasser.
Enchanted.
Enraptured.
Embalmed.
Oh, pardon us.
Quaint, aren't they, but cute.
Good evening, Miss Lulu.
My, but you look charming.
Oh, thank you, boys. You look charming, too. Oh, by the way, may I present Mrs. Smythe Smythe?
Very, very happy, happy.
Shep Hagney.
Oh, Curlington.
Yesington.
May I present Mrs. Smythe Smythe?
You certainly may. Hiya.
I'm charmed.
I kiss your hand, madame.
Isn't he gallant?
Would you please excuse us? Come on, where's that diamond?
In my safe deposit box.
Give it back.
I lost the combination.
Well, what do you know?
Dummy, I hope nobody saw us. I gotta get something to cover this silverware.
Oh.
Fool. Boys, I've been looking for you. Come along.
Yes, sir.
This is the most interesting experiment. I'm very anxious to really talk to those boys. Well, they're here. I know they'll be very happy to speak with you, Mrs. Smythe Smythe.
You petty larceny stooge. What are you trying to do, ruin us? Give me that pie. I'll get over there and sit down before I crown you. Go on.
And you know, my dear, when they first arrived, they were absolutely uncouth. But now they're the epitome of refinement. There's one of them now. Excuse me. My dear young man, do tell me about yourself.
Well, you see, you'll pardon me.
If you don't tell me all about this metamorphosis, I shall always feel that I've missed something.
Lady, if you don't leave right now, you're not going to miss anything.
Young man, what's wrong? You act as though the sword of Damocles is hanging over your head.
Lady, you must be psychic.
Wonder what's wrong with that young man.
Oh! trained imbecile. Are you trying to ruin us too?
You know, you're a little bit too bossy.
I'm too bossy, huh? Wise guy.
You forgot the duck.
So did you.
Oh. Oh, wait. Wait, let's call it
truce. Come on now. Come on, you started this. You.
Pardon me, Matt.
Stop it! Stop it this minute! You disgraceful vagabonds! Oh! 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 So, you want to play rough, do you? Well!
Wait a minute, lady! Oh. Wait a minute, excuse me!
I'll put a stop to this right now. I'll be right back.
A wise guy, eh? How do you like that?
What's going on here? Do you realize that? That does it. This is the end.
Stop!